2,500 miles off the coast of North America and situated in the middle of the Pacific Ocean resides one of the most endangered species on the planet, the Hawaiian monk seal. After thriving for millions of years in the Hawaiian island chain, monk seals are faced with an uncertain future as their population continues to decline at an alarming rate. With only 1,100 of these mammals left, humankind has been given a great responsibility. We are the only beings with the power and creativity to protect and save the Hawaiian monk seal. If you live in or frequent the Hawaiian Islands, you may be familiar with the monk seal. These seals are known by various names in the Hawaiian language, including Ilioholoikawawa, meaning the dog that runs in the rough seas, Nameahulu, meaning the furry ones, and Sila, or Kila. The Hawaiian monk seal is found nowhere else in the world and is one of only two mammals unique to Hawaii. They are protected by both the Endangered Species Act and the Marine Mammal Protection Act. In recent years, despite the decline of their overall population, Hawaiian monk seals have been appearing more in the main Hawaiian islands and can show up on beaches frequented by visitors or residents. Interactions with humans and seals, however, pose new challenges for both people and seals alike. Monk seals spend a surprisingly large amount of time out of the water. Seals rest, molt, or shed their old coat, and give birth to their young on land. Our responsibility as good neighbors to these animals begins at the beach and with the mothers and newborn pups. Mother seals aren't much different from you or me. Like us, they're protective of their children. Approaching pups may be tempting for some people, but if a mother seal senses trouble, she may decide to protect her pup in the only way she knows how, with her teeth. Like any new mother, a monk seal mother needs to be left alone to focus on her pup. Disruptions and distractions can severely interrupt this relationship, causing the mother to leave the pup and not return. The result of this separation is an orphan seal pup now exposed to all sorts of dangers. If left on its own, the seal pup could eventually die. Approaching a young pup poses yet another risk. It is the beginning of the seal's relationship with humans. Pups are very impressionable, and if repeatedly exposed to humans at an early age, they could grow up thinking that it's okay to socialize with humans. This may be cute today, but when the seal grows up to be an adult weighing 500 pounds, this can be a real problem for humans, and eventually the seal. After the seal spends the first part of its life cared for by its mother, the day will come when it's time for the now juvenile, or weaned seal, to be on its own. This happens abruptly at the approximate age of about 6 weeks, when the hungry mother needs to leave the pup on the beach so she can go feed and replenish herself, after over a month of round-the-clock nursing. When the mother seal leaves her pup like this at the end of the nursing period, she usually returns only once or twice for a moment or two. Soon thereafter, she permanently leaves the pup on its own. This is a confusing time for the weaned seal, as it seeks to socialize and continue to nurse from its mother. The juvenile may appear confused and lonely and will likely start to explore anything new. Juveniles are known to try to nurse from or sleep next to turtles, rocks, pieces of wood, debris on the beach, or other young weaned seals. During this time in their life, the weaned seals are also particularly vulnerable to becoming comfortable with interacting with people. It's easy to see the seal behavior as playful, and there might be a temptation to feed these young seals, make eye contact with them, or even swim near them. All of which can quickly lead to seals viewing humans as other animals to be socialized with. This can be a recipe for long-term problems for both seals and humans. Doesn't the idea of wrestling with a 500-pound seal that's mistaken you for another seal sound like a seriously bad idea? Playful seals like to throw their weight around, use their mouths, pull each other underwater, and block each other from getting out of the water. Seals that have become accustomed to humans during their impressionable younger years can mistake humans for a playdate. Encounters in water can lead to seals wanting to swim and even play with humans. They can pull us underwater, block us from leaving the water, and even nip at us. Remember, seals outweigh the average human by 300 to 400 pounds, and they're incredible swimmers. A seal that has been socialized to depend on humans begins to lose its ability to take care of itself in the wild. A fast food diet from the fishing dock or the beach can lead to seals losing the ability to hunt in the wild on their own. ultimately, public safety comes first. If a seal becomes too much for us to handle, because people have made the choice to play with and feed the seal over time, then authorities may be forced to remove that seal from the wild. This poses a risk to the overall recovery of the species, as that seal will no longer be reproducing and adding new pups to the wild population. Remember, this is a unique species, found only in the Hawaiian Islands. It's easy to share the beaches with our neighboring seal population. It's all about space. All we need to do is remind ourselves of our responsibility to protect these animals and give them the space they require to rest or nurse their young. If you see a seal on the beach, remind yourself and politely remind others to keep a distance of at least 150 feet or stay behind any signs or ropes. An easy way to tell if we're far enough away is to extend your arm out in front of you, make a thumbs up sign, turn it sideways, keeping your thumb parallel with the ground, and try to cover up the seal with your thumb. If you can cover the seal with your thumb, you're far enough away. A monk seal on the beach does not mean we can't use the beach. We can still share the beach and observe these special animals, but by giving them space, we all stay safe and promote the well-being of our unique Hawaiian neighbor. We are at a critical moment in time. After thousands of years of living in this world and sharing Hawaii's beaches, Hawaiian monk seals are on the brink of extinction. Humans are the only species on this planet with the power to influence the future of this magnificent mammal. Sharing the same spaces as the monk seals needn't be bad nor dangerous. Learning how to coexist with seals that are sharing the same beaches and oceans with us is the key. As responsible stewards of our environment, let's be respectful of our neighbor animals that don't have the power we have to choose. Common sense is not enough. Let's all make it our personal mission to give these animals the space they need to stay wild by not feeding, playing with, nor approaching them when we see them on the beach. Through these small actions, we give these animals the best chance they have to continue to share Hawaiian beaches and be part of a rich, abundant, and diverse world community for a long time to come.